Let me now get back to that Kabul terror attack story. It has a direct impact on India for more than one reason. The terrorist, the attacker, has been identified as an Indian from Kerala. Remember, 25 Sikh worshippers were killed 2 days ago in Kabul in this terror attack on Gurdwara Har Rai Sahib. Now, Islamic State had claimed responsibility. Islamic State terrorists had targeted the Kabul Gurdwara. Now, one of the terrorists was an Indian from Kasargod in Kerala, an Islamic State terrorist. He's now been identified as Muhammad Muhsin. Now, Muhsin was a 21-year-old engineering student at Kasargod in Kerala before he fled to Afghanistan in 2016 to join the Islamic State. Remember, a number of youngsters from Kerala, highly radicalized by certain elements, they had gone to fight with the Islamic State. They'd started a new module of the Islamic State in Afghanistan. Now, India Today's executive editor, Sandeep Unnithan, breaking this big story for us here on India Today. He joins us for more. Sandeep, this is extremely distressing. An engineering student from Kasargod in Kerala was the terrorist involved in this suicide terror attack at a Gurdwara. What more do we know, not just of this terrorist, but also of the level of radicalization, Sandeep?
Gaurav, what we know so far is that yesterday, ISIS put out a statement identifying one of the three attackers who had targeted the Gurdwara in Kabul, killing 25 worshippers. ISIS called this attacker Abu Khalid al-Hindi. Now, Kerala police are telling us that Abu Khalid al-Hindi is none other than Muhammad Muhsin, a native of Kasargod in Kerala. Muhsin is 21 years old. He's an engineer. He traveled to Afghanistan from Dubai to join ISIS, and he's part of nearly 100 other people from Kerala who have joined ISIS over the last few years. This is a very, very significant development, Gaurav, because this is only the second case of a high-level suicide bomber attacker in ISIS hailing from India. The first case, as you know, is of Shafi Armar, who was used by ISIS in a suicide bomb attack in Raqqa, Syria in 2015. This is only the second case, and Kerala police have reason to believe there are something like 20 to 25 other ISIS operatives from Kerala who are still alive and free to inflict attacks in Afghanistan, as we've just discovered today.
Sandeep Unnithan, for the moment, many thanks for joining me.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.